Explain his question and your answer. What did he ask?
They're asking this. This is what power is. It's power, me taking my body weight and falling into a thing in a pushing sort of way. No, that is not punching power. Punching power is creation and transfer of energy. You know, let me tell you about an old tool called a freaking hammer. Everybody's used a hammer before, but do you really know how a hammer works? Is a hammer heavy and you hit the nail and the weight of the hammer pushes it down? Do I swing it and it gets more weight and that weight pushes it down? No, that's absolutely not what happens. What happens is I hold the hammer, the weight is here, I start generating force with this moment arm, the lever point. Energy in this motion is built up and stored, and it wants to go somewhere. So I use my physical mechanical energy to move this hammer. Now the hammer stores the energy. Now the hammer hits a nail, and that energy explodes and is transferred into the nail, and the nail goes down. And how do you know this is true? Have you ever been at that last swipe of the nail, and sometimes you hit it, and the nail is inset to the wood? How could that possibly happen? Well, the hammer didn't push the nail into the wood. It exploded energy, and the nail almost shot deeper than the portion of the wood. And that's the same thing I was trying to explain to these guys with their punches. So you shouldn't be a force of you pushing. It should be a force of you.
If you took the hammer and pushed it against the nail,
you wouldn't build many houses. Let me tell you.
And just to tell people, you laid down all the wood over here.
Yes.
So you know about nails.
And I actually used a screw gun, but.
Oh, okay. There you have it. Brandon Krause talking about power.
That's all I know.
Don't push. Be the hammer.
Yeah. As hard as he can. And he's going to hold it in place for you. You're going to hit it in as hard as you can 10 times. Just keep switching back and forth until you've completed a double round of that. So one round, the break, and then another round. Okay? Thank you. Go! I don't care about fast right now, I care about hard.
What's the advantage of this drill?
It's a good way to get them to work cardio and use intensity. Intensity is a weird thing because how do you measure intensity, you know? But hopefully that these athletes are using as much intensity as they can for this short 10-punch combination. And then they get the likewise period to rest, so it's like a good 1-to-1 ratio drill. Go up in the ring now with your gloves on. Let's get Art and Knox to run the drill.
Are you supposed to worry about your form, about your technique?
Yeah, yes.
That's later on, one step at a time?
More advanced guys, yeah, their technique should be fight technique. Yes, absolutely.
What you gotta say? You ain't got a technique?
No, no, I was just asking. Because he was talking about the speed and the power. He wasn't talking about fundamentals. All right, let's see your Sergio Martinez 10 times.
I don't want to put a hole in the bag.
Oh, thank you. It's an expensive bag.
I've never seen anyone pop a heavy bag. Except Kelly Pavlik came close.
Oh, man. Look at my old bags. All of them have been ripped and popped and destroyed.
Huh?
If you keep pounding on them long enough, they're going to break.
Fried chicken.
You need some fried chicken?
Yeah, some syrup.
Why?
I'm just kidding. It's a joke.
Oh.
Like, when I'm out of shape, you say. Oh, it's alright, you say.
Not easy. So there you have it, the 10 punch grill right here at Outlaws. Stay tuned, KC3Point.com. I'm Melissa Quack reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at SecBack. Thank you.